Now during our first reading, we heard about Habakkuk. And horrible things were happening at that time with Habakkuk. Habakkuk lived around 600 BC, before our Lord. And during that time, it was a great time of violence. The Babylonians had conquered the Syrians and were threatening to attack the rest of the world, including the kingdom of Judah. So Habakkuk, he calls out to the Lord. God, aren't you aware of what's happening here? I mean, we're all going to be killed. And the Lord responds, have faith. The just one, because of his faith, will live. You know, I was visiting someone the other day, and the person told me, you know, this world is going to hell in a handbasket. Government policies reflect anti-Christian bias. People are struggling but refusing to do anything about their problems, expecting all the other people to bail them out. Now, this world is at the brink of war. But the Lord responds to us today. Live as a just person. One united to me, have faith, and you will live. You know, school seems to be harder and harder than ever for students these days, and also their parents. High school is particularly a difficult time, and so is the middle school, beginning of adolescence, and college that challenges one to move into independence. Students are either attacked for their faith or being pressured to join those who live as though they have no faith. Nothing is more difficult to a teenager than to lose friends. So the teenager calls out to God, how can I keep you and be happy at school? The Lord responds today, just live united to me and have faith. It will work out. The just will live by faith alone. People come to church and often hear the message on this first Sunday of October, Respect Life Sunday. Many find the issue difficult because of the atheistic and anti-theistic positions that people have around the world. And even by people who claim to be people of faith, but who choose positions against life. Now there's the opposite extreme. There are those that feel that the issues or that issue should be the sole concern of the church. And some of these people are upset at the words of Pope Francis when he stated that life issues are not the only concerns of the church. They are major concerns, but not the only concerns. And the everyday Catholic who is confronted with these issues says, you know, this is just all a little bit confusing for me. I mean, what am I supposed to do? How should I react to all these things? And the Lord responds to us today. It's not that difficult. Just stay united to me. Be just, be righteous, and have faith. Then you will live. In the gospel today, the disciples are in a quandary as well. And they say to our Lord, or ask our Lord, Lord, increase our faith. And he responds to them, trust me. Trust me. You know, my sisters and brothers, there are many, many challenges in our lives. And there are many crises that we have to face in our lives. And we wonder if God is aware of what we're going through. But the readings today are telling us God is aware. now have faith. It sounds so simple, and it's certainly easy to say or be up here and preach about. But all of us come to church seeking faith, even the faith of a mustard seed. And we do this every time we pray, but particularly as a faith community, when we hear the word of God and receive the Eucharist from the table of the Lord. Faith requires hard work. Hard work, trust, commitment by you and me between peoples, cultures, and ideologies. We all ask God to help us serve Him in every aspect of our lives. Today, we pray that we might have faith that is strong enough to get us through any of the crises or problems that we face and turn them into opportunities for us to place our trust in God. And we remember Habakkuk. For the just, because of their faith, they shall live.